One coughing fit later. As I was saying, my streaming schedule is all messed up at the time being, as are the episodes, because I've got so much to do, and so it's all random and whatever, and it will be back to normal around a month-ish from now. So, nice to see you, my friend Thea. It's always nice to see you, actually. I don't know you, like, at all, but you've been one of my fans for a really long time, as far as I can tell. You used to comment back on the Dark Souls Let's Play, like, 4 years ago, I think, right? I say one of my fans as if I have any kind of a following whatsoever. Anyway, okay, it is past 6 o'clock, so I'm going to jump in. I have played maybe 15 minutes of this game just to see what it is and to check if it will run on my stream. Yeah, all both of you are my following. So I'm just going to start a new game over again. I was still in the tutorial, but it has a whole kind of a thing that it sets up, so I might as well.
Are you filled with feelings of self-doubt? Do you find yourself prone to minimizing massive dilemmas, or for allowing the smallest problems to get blown completely out of proportion? At the Pierce Institute, our patent-pending SomnoSculpt technology provides safe and effective dream therapy while you rest in the comfort of our flagship clinic. Located right next to the secondary overflow parking lot at the University Medical Center. SomnoSculpt, we'll make your dreams come true.
I'm sure it's unintentional, but that music really strongly reminds me of Theme Hospital, which sort of matches the same theme of kind of terrible healthcare that's sort of awful for everyone. This is a 3D puzzle game, which... everybody's favourite clever trick at the opening of a 3D puzzle game. Which fucks around with space and time and volume and space. And I said space twice, but that's fine. So it's... The, like, 15 minutes of it I've seen so far aren't especially... you know, amazingly clever. There's one basic mechanic, which is this, which is that you can recontextualize things, and based on how you recontextualize them, their volumes are changed. So I can make it tiny, and I can make it even tinier. I don't know if there's a minimum size, or I think there's a maximum size based by the rooms you're in, because it takes effort to make them big again. But the... I didn't get out of the tutorial in the 10 minutes I was playing before, so... Like, I'm hard-pressed to make it any bigger now. Oops. Anyway, that's just stuff. Perception is reality. Grab. So yeah, make things tiny, smooth and out of the way, jump over stuff. I have played a lot of...
Service accepted. Congratulations on falling asleep. Welcome to SomnoSculpt. Your progress may be monitored by qualified specialists. This orientation will adapt you to eyelids, our interactive, lucid induction dream state in which you retain full consciousness and control.
This isn't a puzzle, I'm just playing around. Is there a way to... I can spin them, but I don't know if I can, like, reshape them so that they stand up properly or... Do I have to bump them off of things to make that happen? No. Well, this is irrelevant. Anyway. So I think there's... Yeah. If I do this, I can get up there. Pawn to d4. I'm actually really bad at chess. I just watched all of The Queen's Gambit with my flatmate in like 4 days. But I learned nothing about chess by doing so. So, if you've ever played any 3D puzzlers like Antechamber or Portal, of course, then this is all intimately familiar. I have the defense of having played through these tutorial rooms already, so I do know the solutions. I won't tell you how long some of them...
Confirmed. You can move freely, interact with surrounding objects, and listen to messages from your patient care team. Please note that I am the standard orientation protocol and that my voice has been explicitly chosen to remind you that I am not a part of your patient care team. I do not care.
There's the same kind of sense of humor as all of these things as well. It's got some Stanley Parable energy, I think. This is Cheese, which is going to be showing up again for other puzzles later. Cheese will solve most of your problems in life, I think. Unless you're lactose intolerant, in which case it causes many of them.
During eyelids, you will lose the ability to awaken suddenly due to realizing that this is a dream. Evidence. I have already informed you that this is a dream. You did not wake up. Please complete the remaining orientation activities.
I like that instead of just removing those, you can shrink them away so that they're not a problem.
Warning, you have deviated from the orientation pathway. At the Pierce Institute, patient safety is a key node in our corporate priority tetrahedron. A variable degree of force can and will be authorized to ensure patient safety. Please return to the orientation pathway.
Ultimately, though, it is kind of so far been telling the same kind of jokes in the same kind of way, which is slightly disappointing, but I do think it's an innovative mechanic, at least. I mean, the Dream Soda Machine had mini, normal-sized soda, didn't it? I mean, that's what normal-sized soda cans are like. That's a mini can. I mean, I think in America, everything is classified as a soda if it comes out of a... Actually, is this in America? That voice was American, but the, what would you call it? The voiceover at the beginning. It's definitely Scottish. In fact, I swear to God, it's the same Scottish voice actor that does all of the voice acting for any of these kind of satirical tongue-in-cheek video games with satirical tongue-in-cheek healthcare situations. Oh, this is slightly irritating. I remember I had trouble with this earlier. Because I need to make it the right size to get through that hole. Can I make it as small as possible if I do this? Does it have? It looks like it might have a minimum size, actually, which is that, then. Will you fit now? That's the real question. And the answer is no. That must be as small as I can make it. It's the size of my little grabby hand. There we go.
Environments perceived during eyelids should reflect a typical mental state. If you believe your mental state was compromised by Somnasculpt, please provide a comprehensive, rational explanation in your post-procedural survey. Completed surveys may be eligible for a gift card.
But it does have that kind of, And yeah, I didn't forget that cubes can push buttons, like... I'm pretty sure this is literally here just to show us that they're going to elide space as well as objects, because this is, of course, this corridor comes out there. This corridor comes out there. It's a perfect loop. I did try to kill myself by dropping a huge weight on my own head, but it did nothing. You are way less physically embodied in this game than in most 3D puzzlers that I've played, less than in... the Talos Principle, and in, obviously, Portal, which had a lot of quite careful embodiment, I think. It can be really hard to judge whether it's going to fall on things. So I think I was maybe one room further than this.
Please stand by for polite recognition on your completion of the Somnasculpt orientation. You did it. To maximize the time allotted for your therapeutic journey, please do not delay in proceeding through the final doorway as indicated.
This actually stumped me for a bit. I could see through these holes, but I couldn't figure out what to do. But it turned out what to do was to... Well, I can't... Make it big and make it bump. and then the things fall over, but I couldn't actually shove them or push them with my own body weight, so I had to figure out how to make this fall on them. Which does not now seem to be working. Oh well. Maybe I just make it as big as possible. This guy's the guy in charge of all of this. He's the big cheese. Because obviously if I walk into a wall, it recontextualizes the cheese and makes it smaller, which is not what I need. Oh, ha! This one fell down. Hooray for coughing! Yay! Right, this is as far as I've gone. So any puzzles after this point are going to be me hemming and hawing and umming and aahing as I try to actually solve the damn things. Maybe I should take the cheese with me just in case. Where did it go? There it is. Haha! At the very least I'll have a snack for later. So I've enjoyed a lot of kind of 3D puzzle games and... okay. Very clever. I've enjoyed a lot of 3D puzzle games over the years, including... very good, very good. Although I think someone already made that pun, actually. I thought they told me I wasn't gonna just randomly wake up, although this is obviously still in the dream, right? This is another layer of the dream world. I really should play more kind of weird liminal indie games. I've got tons of them and I never really get around to playing them. I've got Kentucky Route Zero, which is dreamlike, and I mean I loved the Stanley Parable ages ago when that came out. The Dream Machine. Actually Dr. Langesker, the Tiger in the Horribly Cursed Emerald is quite good as well, although that's less directly dreamlike. But they all seem to have this aesthetic. Maybe is this just like the Unity Store assets aesthetic? Oh, I should have got random soda. Red, green, diet, random baking soda. Oh, and this is the mini soda you mentioned. I wonder if you order mini soda, it's actually smaller. I don't want this. Hey! I'd love to get achievements for being a responsible consumer. Hey, come on, where's my soda? No service ever, huh? Well, I guess it is a dream thing. Yeah, you're right. There is a lineage directly between like the kind of generic source assets and this, but the thing about the generic source assets in like Gary's Mod and all that stuff. Yeah, I know. I played the mod before it came out as a game, actually. Those things had sort of a texture. There's a kind of a gritty texture to all of the like generic source assets, which is appealing to me, but is also not this aesthetic. This is very kind of smooth. In fact, it's almost like generic pre-rendered assets from like, what would you call them? Old. Okay, well that's... this is not fire safe, this is extremely questionable. Anyway, there's a kind of a lineage to old multimedia... is that what you'd call it? Like, 3D assets from games that used pre-rendered images and other such. Okay. There's no duck button, so I can't see what's down there. But if you think about like pre-rendered 3D images or basic 3D animations in the 90s, that's kind of what I'm imagining. Something off of an Encarta DVD or CD-ROM even before DVDs. That one does nothing too. If I make this small. Hey, look, now it's adorable. I don't need this. Right. I swear to God, that adorable pun better earn me some followers. I do like how much more kind of playful it is rather than something like antechamber, which is almost... Oh, nice, trompe l'oeil. It is impressive that... That really works, what the fuck? The degree to which they're willing to be playful and have these things be not, you know, clever 3D engine tricks, but straight up trompe l'oeil like you would do in the real world. Trompe l'oeil, for anyone who doesn't know, being the term for a form of art which projects out or outwards from or into the canvas in order to give the illusion of 3D space. Or occupies 3D space in the way to make it look like a window into another world, that kind of thing. Comes from the French for fool the eye. I know these things because I failed in art school. Can I open any of these doors? Can't pick up any of these things. Maybe because these are... aha! Okay. Can I make this big enough to climb over with? I think it can tell what I'm trying to do. It would make sense if they'd programmed in, like... I do think so. I feel like they're less like they're leaning outwards and a bit- oh! Aha! Okay. Well, I can say that I failed in that I ended up not completing my course and not achieving any kind of qualification out of it, which is kind of the definition for academic failure. And also I didn't learn about trompe l'oeil in art school. I learned that because my granddad's a painter and my mum's a painter, and they taught me, like, from childhood how to do art things. Okay, can I climb that? That looks climbable. Aha! Problem solved. Oh, I want to go to StairCon. I can't believe I missed this year's. They had some speakers from Stana about the stairlift revolution. It was amazing, but I had to watch it on stream because of 2020, you know. What is... Yeah, exactly. Like I said. See, I feel like the advantage to treating someone for psychotherapy in their actual dreamscapes is that you don't need the effort of designing everything. You can just have their own subconscious pull stuff out. And the fact that they're dreaming means they will accept anything anyway. Like, I've had some really rad shit happen in my dreams, and I've never been like, oh, you know, the verisimilitude of this isn't high enough. Like, why are they building stuff out of plywood if it's my dream? These are all the clever tricks they've used. Cubes. Pirates. Aluminium. Symmetrical. Layouts. Balsa wood. Ply. Corrugated. Cloud insert. Projection. These are just a whole bunch of words. Yeah, see, this is actually a hidden message from the developers about game piracy. But anytime I play a game like this, I obsessively end up searching for little secrets and stuff. I need a torch. Is there, like, a torch button? Let's see. Vertical moves, grab. Grab is mouse click, right? Yeah. Jump, rotate. It's weird that you still have, like, look binding. Oh, is that what those were? I have done digital art, but I always tend to forget that hex codes are a thing, even though I regularly use them. Yeah, you're right. That must be the hex code for actual blue. What was I saying? Oh yeah, games like this, they love to play with the parameters of simulation. Obviously the Stanley Parable was kind of the entire basis of its humor, was constantly undermining, redefining, and allowing you to play with the parameters of the simulation and the extents to which you can escape and can make your own stuff happen and all of that stuff.
My name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and I'd like to talk to you about being special. So special, in fact, that we have no idea where you are. But not to worry, we're working on it.
Okay, so this is like a medical science fuck-up, right? They've lost me in my own brain. Which is an experience I can relate to as someone severely brain-fucked. What was I talking about? Oh, I was talking about the boundaries of simulation. Because there's kind of a fundamental disingenuity in all of those sorts of things, where the joke is that they show you what the simulation is and the boundaries of the simulation and teach you to manipulate those things. And then there's, you know, some kind of revelatory moment where you realise that actually it's not if I make this a cube, can I grab it? Hey! I'm a genius. Actually, this has really strong... I know we were saying this earlier, but this has really strong energy of those kinds of 90s CG renders. I was feeling really nostalgic for that era of software a week or two ago. I looked up a whole bunch of educational software from the 90s. Multimedia CD-ROMs and even games of that era. There's a kind of... Myst had that aesthetic, for example, with the... all of the objects in that world looking and feeling very much like these kinds of objects. I think something's been lost from that era, or I might just be old and nostalgic. That's also an option. Or is anything in here? No. But kind of shiny, smooth wood textures and, you know, shadowy lighting with no kind of detail and repeating patterns on carpets, all of that kind of stuff. Anyway, the boundary of simulation, all of these things always kind of... Hello, what's this? Have a... Oh, I have to line up to that as well. There we go. That's clever. This is just kind of delightful. It's so playful, which is appealing to me as compared to a lot of the kind of tongue-in-cheek irony these kinds of experiences have. It allows its humour to come primarily from the mechanics. That's gotta be right, right? Hey. Oh, interesting. Huh. But, yeah, they set up expectations about the nature of reality, and then they undermine them, and then they allow you to break them. But ultimately, you're only ever breaking the system in the ways that the people who designed the system wanted you to break it. While something like the Stanley Parable might borrow the aesthetic of something more like, speedrunny, breaking out of the simulation kind of stuff, there isn't actually any kind of real truth to that. Because you can't, actually, go do what you want. And you are only discovering the things that they will let you do, because that's what the game is, that's how it works. There is only in the game what the designers have decided to put in the game. And that remains the case. There's also a nice little quality of life mechanic, which is that if you get roughly in the right position, it sort of gently scoots you slightly so that you line up correct. See, the writing in this isn't where the humour comes from, and it's usually where the writing where the humour comes from in this style of game. You know, it's GLaDOS being extremely horny at you, or it's the narrator in the Stanley Parable getting salty at you. There isn't this kind of, we duct taped this doorframe on here. Kind of, because a lot of humour comes from subversion of expectations. So if you set up an expectation and then subvert it, that's usually inherently funny.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and I'm just popping in to give you a quick update on where you are. We still don't know, but please keep moving forward, and hopefully you prefer frequent updates to being reminded that you are completely lost.
See, like, the humour from the writing isn't the same. The humour that comes from playing with an object and finding out you can do something with it is kind of a pure delight. It comes from a pure place of play. You know, in real life, I have, you know, moved an object in a way I didn't know it could, found something inside something, and expressed genuine delight, been surprised by it. And this sort of thing evokes that same sort of feeling, which is not something that you see very often in video games. I do think something has been lost from that era, both the wonder of it, which again might just be because I was a child at the time, and I am now a sad adult, and might also be part... Oh, spooky. Oh, hey. Is that the door I came in from? No, that's the door I came in from. Okay, so... Is there something up there that I can have a look at? Oh, I can't do a chin-up. Come on. Yeah, there we go. I can do a chin-up. Great, okay. So this must be another secret area, right? Because it's not obvious. Yep. That's cool. What else is in there? Secret things. Chess pieces. Actually, now that I think about it, quite a few of the kind of generic objects that you would get in those kinds of, you know, the menus of multimedia CD-ROMs in the 90s were these kinds of things. Chess pieces, chess boards, marble objects, flower pots, or vases rather. There's a kind of a... There's kind of a concept of the, like, perfectly generic object, not to, you know, borrow Homestuck terms or anything. Which I, like, I believe that objects are kind of invested with a certain degree of power based on our understandings of them as human beings and how we think about things. And, is it possible to... Okay, so that always gives the pawn face up, which I feel like is very, making a very unsubtle thematic point about the fact that we are the pawn in the game designer's, you know, stratagem. Just like every other game that has ever told a story that has been like, aha, you're just doing what we tell you. Which is such a trite point for a video game to make, because as I was saying before, you can only ever do the things in the game that the game designers expected you to do, and they can only ever comment on the things that they expected you to do. If you truly break a game, if you do speedrunner bullshit, then they can't possibly comment on it because they don't know you can do it when they make the game.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and we still can't find you. But you should now have access to a series of elevators that should trigger your subconscious to gradually wake you up. You should also find a variety of emergency exit signs that should lead you to them. Will all of this work? Absolutely.
What if I don't want to wake up, Glenn? What if I want to live in this fascinating simulation for the rest of my brain life? Maybe I'm nostalgic enough for 90s computing that I want to go back. I want to live in this place with its jazzy piano and its inexplicable chess pieces. Oh, yes, but like chess pieces are kind of one of those perfectly generic objects that kind of represent concepts, and because there are sort of thematic associations tied to almost everything, and it's interesting to play with those. I tried to think about it the other day. See, the issue with having an Easter egg like that is, how do they make the game recognize that you've done that if you do it in one of the ways they weren't expecting? And if you do it the way they were expecting, then you still haven't really escaped the bounds of their planning, have you? Oh, I wonder if I've missed any of those. I'm sure pulling all of the fire alarms does nothing, but... Or maybe they do things. Okay, what am I missing? Can I grab the moon? Sometimes I'm playing a game and I'm like, oh, I'm a genius. An achievement would make sense, yeah. Games are fun and I'm a genius. That's why I do this. I do feel like I am very on point today with all of my rambling.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce. In the event that this elevator does not wake you up, please don't interact with anything that strikes you as psychologically significant, as we will no longer have any way of controlling it. For example, if you see your parents, please punch them in the face as hard as you can and immediately run away.
Yeah, sure. That's sensible. That's completely reasonable advice. My dude, this is my subconscious. Everything that is here is made of symbolism. Like, this is what I was starting to talk about before I got distracted by something, like I always do. Aha! See, I did get an achievement for pulling all the fire alarms. I don't have ADHD or anything. What the fuck was I about to say? Oh god, I had a whole point about something to do with semiotics, and it's gone. What if there's a fire in elevator? Regular person, 3 to 5 dreams per night. Beer fund, $5, Dakota. Don't meet sister-in-law. Well, this all seems like sensible advice. Oh, hey, phone. Nope, nothing. God, I was gonna talk about... Yes, okay, this is the dreamscape, right? This is the dream world. So don't interact with things that have personal symbolism. But everything has symbolism, which is what I was talking about before when I was talking about the chess piece. The reason why the chess piece is... That's cute. The reason why the chess piece is one of these perfectly generic objects that is very common, you know. For thematic purposes, people have a lot of things they come back to. A cage, you know? A lighthouse. A chess piece. A floppy disk. And that's because we invest everything, every day of our lives, with symbolism and meaning, which means that objects that have become more heavily invested with meaning simply by their prevalence in pop culture, in media, in literature, have a greater level of that meaning. So it's ridiculous to say try and escape from things that have symbolic weight when everything can have a symbolic weight. This computer has symbolic weight because there are thematic associations we can draw from the presence of a chunky, boxy old PC monitor. You know, that is an image that smells to me like burning dust, because I spent loads of time growing up in my dad's office, which was full of dust and old PCs, you know? Let's have the mini soda. It's tiny! How big can I make it? Yeah, it is a really good smell. Like, it smells very much like all of this, like, 90s multimedia software I'm talking about smells. It won't fit any bigger. Oh well. I'm keeping this one. I like the tiny soda.
This is an automated message for all patients who attempted to use an alternate pathway to access the next phase of Somnasculpt therapy, but who have become trapped in a dream state paradox instead. Your decisions imply a failure of orientation, which reflects negatively on the standard orientation protocol. You will rectify this failure immediately.
So they're saying it's not my fault I got trapped in the dreamscape, because it was their orientation that fucked up. However, it's also my responsibility to fix it. I'm not an employee, I'm like a test subject, come on. Curators only. Anyway, I feel like I have done an amazing job today, so far, on being very on and talking about all kinds of incredibly interesting topics. Oh, that's kind of painful to look at. I've always hated optical of... No, it's not really an illusion, but like... op art, nonsense like that. More quote, hidden unquote messages. Also, 1991, so it does actually match the era for those big chunky CG renders, which is very entertaining to me. Wiring diagram for... But for what? I signed a waiver. I didn't sign... Like, a waiver is a waiving of my own rights. It's not necessarily a claiming of responsibility for something else. Who's leaving trash in my subconscious? That's incredibly irresponsible. Can I get that out of there? Can I put it in the bin? This is like elaborate psychosurgery, right? So It's not even my fault. Who put this trash in my brain? Haha, that's cute. See, again, it sets up something and then subverts it. It's fascinating to me that this can be so clever in its simplicity of its visual and physical humor. Just the delight from discovering things like, you know, you looked at this the right way and it became something else. So it's kind of tiresome to me that they insist on having these other gags that don't work as well. Because honestly, the verbal humor that other games of this type have done is so much funnier. Is that? If I go down there, I probably can't come back up, so I do want to see what's up here first. Aha! I can't get through that. But yeah, for example, the gag of the secret die, the loaded dice, which always faces upwards.
Tip, the average adult can only withstand 3 to 5 dreams per night. Once this threshold is eclipsed by entering more dreams, your mind will suffer an explosive mental overload, reorienting you for the emergency exit protocol. Please subject yourself to explosive mental overload.
Oh, honey, that happens like once a week at least. No gag for the baking soda one. If I shake it, will it explode? I like that it makes different notes based on the side. That is a nice touch. I could just play with this all day. But I won't. Oh, hang on. Was there something I was going to do back here? I fell down the hole. No, there wasn't anything. Oh, what does this one say? I can't read it. You can't expect me to read things like some kind of smart person. What have we done? That is a good question. Something wrong anyway. Did I? Oh my god, it gave me a second one? All of the other ones have been broken. Oh, no, okay. I've just leveled up from one soda to two sodas, I guess. Baking soda, what have we done? It's a good okay. Anyway, yeah, no, I was talking about the gag of the always showing a pawn whenever you roll it, just, you know, thereby showing that you are trapped here and you have to do what we say. Which is the same joke that every slightly tiresome writer in the games industry who thinks he's being clever wants to say. Ooh, we made you do something. Isn't it interesting that you did the thing that we made you do? I'm like, yeah, like, of course I did the thing you made me do, because it was the only thing there was to do in the game. Like, you're not clever for saying otherwise you should walk away, because, like, it's the game. Like, that's what it is. Oh, okay. Zoop. Okay, well, that one's... Can I do that with... Yeah, okay. Okay, sliding block puzzle, I guess? So I guess this is gonna mean I need to girl like substance. That's extremely funny and you should be proud. I'm only not laughing because I'm puzzling. Are there more of these on the walls that I can't see? If I jump up here, that doesn't help me. Can I jump onto that from here? Nope. What happens if I climb it? Can I lift it while I'm on it? I cannot. Oh, that's probably just enough to jump straight up from, right? Yeah. I'm nimble. Is that just a red herring then? Is there something up here? I feel like I'm missing something in this room. Oh well. One of the other things I've learnt while playing these games is that I'm very bad at them.
Please note that a reluctance to volunteer for the risks associated with explosive mental overload implies a misunderstanding of all other solutions, all of which are far more traumatic and likelier to result in catastrophe. I am not capable of suboptimal suggestions. Please exit this dream as soon as possible.
I am not capable of suboptimal suggestions is a really strong energy and I'm here for it. I think I've missed some of these fire alarms. Oh well. But, I'm good at these games when they're easy. I'm really bad at them when they're hard. Which is apparently a very funny thing to say based on the reaction it got in my room. But I usually do have a great deal of trouble. I never got very far in antechamber because I just got stuck immediately, like, and constantly. And even portal, like, I never had a great deal of ease, although that was more because I would have trouble with the just there's a lot of kind of make work in that game where you know what you have to do and you just have to figure out the positioning to make it happen. Was that a mind explosion? Have I been in this hallway? That looks like an exit. What happens if I go back up? Oh, I can't grab these. Maybe I should get into the habit of carrying something with me. I don't know if anyone's played Spelunky, which I have some hot takes about that I will eventually get to some other time. But one of the things in that game is that it's very useful to just carry an object with you at all times because you can use it to trigger traps. It's not obvious that you should do that, but once you realize that it works, it's really effective. Testers so far: Jonas Dawson, Arthur Willis, Bojo Smith. No, Jojo Smith. That's less of a dumb name. Bart Blagoff? Blayoff? You are here in the pie, dream layers of the mind. Some about halfway down to the subconscious or halfway up to consciousness? Emotions affect dreams. Who knew that? Never would have guessed. People only dream of ordinary objects. Boring. See, but these aren't ordinary objects. A light bulb is so heavily loaded with meaning. Like, come on. Can I decide how far up or down I go? Are they advertising? Is that just something that's in my dream? Is that something my subconscious has spun up? Or have these people actually put advertisements in my subconscious? Because, like, on the one hand, that's exactly the kind of thing they would do. On the other hand, how dare they? I find that personally offensive, and I'm also terrified that that is where we are heading in the world. Oh yeah. They say this isn't there a thing about, like, not being able to see your reflection in dreams? Like, one of the ways you can tell you're in a dream is not being able to read things, they say. Although that's completely untrue, because I've had dreams where I've read really fun, entertaining books and then been disappointed when I woke up and couldn't get the ending. Alright, Glenn, what have you got for us this time?
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and despite touring the Waterfall Serenity Zone in the previous section you've just completed, you may still be experiencing feelings of worthlessness and self-doubt. Why do I feel like everything is going wrong? Even when the sun is shining.
Well, geez, that doesn't sound like where I just was. Maybe the arbitrary mystic- Oh no, fire alarm. Yes, thank you for pointing that out. This one's a different colour. I have a sneaking suspicion that this is supposed to look like it's just the lighting is different, but actually they're a different colour to solve the issue of having multicoloured lighting, maybe. Oh god, I was going to say something about something. Don't know what it was. Something about games? Something. So I was definitely going to say something about games. I think that's a safe assumption. Which of these have I not had? Random soda. Now, are you a randomized one of the sodas I can pick? Or are you random flavor? Are you soda that is random? Do you go rower on the internet at people wearing cat ears? That's the real question. I guess it is just random. Oh, I forgot I was going to start carrying things. Just in case I need to trigger a dart trap. This isn't a spooky corridor at all. That's not a spooky noise at all. It's fine though, I have my emotional support soda. So I feel like this is maybe the subconscious that I'm not supposed to go to, but what happens if I do actually retreat? Because obviously Stanley Parable was a very short game and was about exploring all the different branches of a narrative in a very short sequence of events. This is a longer game, I think. So how much Is there a branch in the narrative, or am I just... this just goes back to where I was, okay. I thought there might have been something else, but nope. Disappointing. I'm very tempted now, though, to just kind of do a run of streaming short indie games, that kind of thing. Oh, I remember what I was going to say. When I was talking about putting advertising in dreams, that reminded me that I played through Hypnospace Outlaw recently, which I thought was delightful, and also absolutely sent me back to that era of computing in a way that was uncomfortably, intensely nostalgic, and absolutely made me long for the innocence of childhood and the delight of exploring and discovering things like this for the first time. Well, not things like this game, things like, you know, software when you're a child. Okay, okay, we're just playing a different game now. This is everybody's trite indie horror game. What do we call this, everybody? This is environmental storytelling. See, that's cute. Electrical shock has behind door. Oh wait, no, they probably mean this door, not this door. I guess that's less funny than I thought it was. Can I jump over these? Oh, I can just move them. I wonder if I'd try and jam one in the door before it shut, if I'd been fast enough. And then maybe I could have seen what was in there. Oh well. Probably not, though. See, things like this with these flat edges. Oh, hey. Oh, interesting. Highly curious. Okay. I found some areas on purpose before, but I think this one's by accident. How far back into the dock can I go? Exactly this far. So there's a hallway like this on either side, which is apparently where I store my plants. Because you know everybody has that little area of your subconscious where you keep all of the plants that you... you know, you swore you would water them. And you did. You did for a while. For a few months at least, but then you started to forget. And most days you still watered them, but less and less. And then slowly less and less, and less and less. And eventually it wilted away and you never even noticed, and it sat behind your desk until all its leaves were gone. And you're haunted by every single one of these plants you've murdered. Haunted your whole life. But maybe that's just me. It looks like this is the same on both sides. Oh, I can fit through this one though. Huh, okay, so that looks like it goes to a doorway. So... is that going to link up to the other side of this? Oh, it looks like I struck a nerve, huh? Oh, wait, no, I forgot you were a small sprout. I'm sorry for my insufficient lack of care for your people. Murder, 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 and beans! So I guess that's disappointing. That's not like a secret hidden area that you're supposed to find. Or that you're supposed to maybe find. This is just the way you are, in fact, supposed to go. Which loops back around to that thing I was saying before about, you know, all of these, like, games about breaking the simulation. You never really actually break anything. I'd like to think that they're kind of making a satirical joke about the tricks used in trite horror games, but to be honest, it feels like they're just trying to genuinely spook me, and it's just, they're just doing everything. There's a blood trail on the floor, doors are shutting. We'll probably see like a wheelchair soon. And there'll just be like one wheel of the wheelchair spinning as if something perhaps came this way recently. Okay. Can I double jump? How video games is this? Oh, there's a plank across it, right? Is there a plank? I thought there was a plank. Maybe I just have to... Now, oh, come on. I knew they were going to do that. You just know whoever designed this was sitting there with a really smug look on his face. That's kind of how I feel about a lot of these games. Antichamber's designer definitely was just sitting there, you know, quietly rubbing his enormous hard on the entire time, like, out of his head on glee at the idea of people falling in holes that they couldn't possibly have seen.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce. And I'd like to talk more about the feelings of worthlessness and self-doubt I mentioned before. You feel this way because you want the kind of happy life you see all around you. And you know everyone else is enjoying. And that's exactly why we're here to help.
Look, I will dunk on any game I am bad at. Just because you've got, like, an enormous brain with seventh dimensional thinking that lets you solve abstract puzzles. It's not my fault. Look, I can analyze a narrative like anybody's business, and I have Twitch skills to back up my pro gamer status. However, I am empty of head and thick of ass, alright? I'm not even that thick of ass, really. You know, I've literally forgotten what I was talking... I remember what I was going to say. I was going to talk about how they have accurately captured the kind of, what do you call it? The sort of condescending therapist voice. My god, it's that chess piece. It's been chasing me this whole time. Oh, nice. See, that's another fun cheeky little thing. Finding the, I mean... I can't tell if you're joking about the soda, but the reason why there's all the diet soda is because it keeps being blocked by objects so that it says not diet, but die. Yeah, antechamber is just really fucking difficult.
Warning. You were advised to subject yourself to explosive mental overload by descending into additional dreams, but have now descended into a dream within a dream instead, disorienting yourself even further. You are responsible for failing to make this crucial distinction.
Yeah, this does feel kind of like... That's how corporation run things be, I guess. Sucks to be you. Right, I can't move these planks. And I can't duck to get through here. I don't think I can pick any of these objects up. There haven't really been, like... puzzles you have to solve so far. It's kind of just presented me with options. Oh, not even options. It's just kind of presented me with an object and an obvious way to use that object. It's kind of press button to continue puzzle design rather than actually requiring abstract thinking. I should make up a whole list of things to go through like this. Maybe Hypnospace Outlaw? Definitely. I should aha! Right, I can grab that, but how does that help me? Oh, I can use it as a torch, maybe? So if I, yeah, exactly that kind of fucking thing. Oh, I can't take that through there, okay. Aha! I'm a genius. I'm not, actually. I do feel like a genius every time I solve a puzzle in most puzzle games, but I feel like very much this is... Here is a tool. This tool has an obvious use. Use the tool in the obvious way. Which is normally the first puzzle in a sequence of puzzles in a puzzle game. They set up, this is what you... Which one of these have I not had? I've had water soda, I've had mini soda, I've had baking, random. I guess red soda? Red flavour. I do enjoy these snarky little, what would you call them? Yeah, a Tinker Toy is kind of, when I was talking about the delight of playing with an object and discovering that it does something, that's literally what it is. It is that kind of... Can I grab that now from the other side? No. It is that kind of, unfettered joy at... The unfettered joy of experimenting with an object and finding that it does something that you weren't expecting. Are those holes or not? I can't tell. I guess not. Maybe I don't need this? I bet I needed it. Red flavor? Red flavor of what? Or do you mean like soda that's flavored with like carmine red or something has a particular underlying flavor that she likes particularly? It's just occurred to me, I've just been banging on about how this game is entirely, you know, press A to continue puzzles. And then here I am, stumped on a fucking doorway. This is the first one I've had to think about, and I have no idea what I'm doing wrong. Nope, okay, I thought I saw a doorway, but that's not the case. Let me through! But, oh yeah, I started this thought earlier, but I can't remember if I finished it, which is that, they have accurately captured no, that's locked as well. Emergency generator. If I throw this away, will it disappear? No. If I throw it in the bin, will it disappear? No. Okay, well, I'm missing something, definitely. Right, shed some light on this. I'm absolutely taking suggestions from the chat, by the way, if anyone has any idea. I thought for sure I would just have to drop this over that wall, but... Anyway, it accurately catches the kind of condescending way that mental health professionals talk to you when they think that you are some kind of fucked up fool. And that they have all the answers. Which, I was going to put in a more eloquent way, but I'm now starting to get frustrated, which is why I don't play puzzle games much, because I do just get frustrated when I can't figure out any way to make any progress. Did I see a hand icon? Is that... No, that's just a wall. Put the light somewhere specific, huh? Well, I can't take it through to the other side of here. Is there something on the ceiling? No. So it must be on this side that I have to put it, right? If I turn it around, can it shed light through the wall? No, it can't. It doesn't... Like, it isn't actually shedding light through the wall, is it? What if I make it massive? Ah, aha. I'm a fool. I am a fool with no brain. So yeah, my problem here is basically that it didn't occur to me that the basic mechanic of this game, the one thing I've been doing the whole way through, the first mechanic it taught me, resizing objects, I just haven't resized anything for a while. It didn't occur to me that that might work.
Did you know that unintentional multi-dream layering occurs in less than 1% of patients? This correlates strongly with the 99% of patients who are able to follow simple instructions from the standard orientation protocol.
That seems rude, frankly. Also, no, I don't have any shadow. I don't have a reflection, I don't have a shadow. Oh, can I grab the torch? No, I can just switch it on and off. Ah, the knife's gone. Spooky. Is this supposed to be a satire on the extremely trite tropes? And I keep saying trite, but like, they are. Is there... See, now that's fun. I like that joke. Taking the, like, IKEA to IDEA is just a fun little pun for something dream-based, isn't it? Okay, I guess the joke is, it wasn't blood, it was paint all along. Which is a joke I've seen elsewhere. And doesn't really undo the whole kind of... extremely seen it before-ness of some of that kind of stuff. Yeah. Beans? Do I need the beans, or am I just having fun with beans? I guess if this is all in the same place, we've seen the hotel rooms of the hotel. Oh, you had a robot ex-girlfriend? Is this the same one as the one? I think this is identical to the... Did it? I don't know if it had this bit before, but I think we definitely saw the rest of this board before. Anyway, this reminds me, I do want to... Oh, avocado. An avocado. Thanks. Need to sleep. Cloning, biggest question, which is the real one. So is this saying that cloning is going to be the mechanic for the next area? See, I've tried to enjoy avocados, but they give me a tummy ache every single time. I am the saddest millennial. They're gonna run out of jokes for the loading screen eventually. My uncle genuinely used to do this. When they share a flat, he straight up had, I think, 7 alarm clocks by his bed, each set 5 minutes separate. And when he woke up in the morning, he would sleep through all 7 of them, and my mum would have to come in and switch them all off one by one and shake him awake. Which, I guess, you could argue meant that they were really alarm clocks for her, not for him. But it's still very much, my god, he was a sleepy motherfucker. Oh, the jazz is back. Am I having an experience of mental stability? Oh, someone bolted the chess piece to the floor. Tragic.
Unfair, it should be on the ceiling.
So, I guess that means I need to figure out some way of detaching them or something. This one's green on top. Yeah, see, apparently a lot of people know people who set multiple alarms. See, because it's the future and we don't need to rely on mechanical alarm clocks anymore, I do actually set 4 alarms on my phone if I need to make sure I get up 5 minutes apart each. Now, see, this is an abstract dreamscape where anything... Can I just take this? Can I just put this on it? There's no wiggly thing here. Yeah, that was easy. Clearly I should be carrying something like it's spelunky. Ah, interesting. How many are there? See, I thought I'd be able to throw it in the bin, but... I think it was 5 I liked. Yep, I'm gonna go with 4. So that was a completely useful aside. So I can't move these at all, but I can clone them freely. How do I? See, that is exactly the moment of delight that I was talking about previously. But I guess if I can't move these, then that's just showing me how it works. Pop. Oh, I see this. This is a staircase. I'm a genius. I wonder if creating all of these extra things to have in my, like, occupying my mental bandwidth in the background is going to cause any kind of additional psychological problems.
Dr. Pierce requires you to note the following risks of dream overexposure. Significant memory loss, both quantitative and qualitative. Hallucinations of dreaded or annoying objects. Unrealistic beliefs about the lengths of hallways. And other side effects which have not yet been discovered or which cannot be understood.
Please bear in mind, if you have become incredibly fucked up as a result of this experience, we accept no responsibility, etc. I did actually want to tip them over like dominoes, which is why I was disappointed that I couldn't grab them as well as clone them. Am I just no longer allowed to resize things? Just one mechanic for this zone? Okay. Right-click to return. Okay. So, I have now gained the ability to also... if I do it from outside the doorway... if I do it like that, does it? Yeah, okay. So the music exists only in the hotel spaces, not outside here. Is this... can I open this? That looks super openable. This, I should just go closer. I should just grab it like that and then do... yeah, that's smarter. That's a cleverer way of doing that, huh? This has village hall energy, weirdly. That's fine. That works. That's good, right? We can do this. Yeah. Remember to see up. I clutter up my unconscious with any more trash than is already in here. Is it the same date? March 1991. Okay, cool. So I'm not like... oh. I'm a smiley face? Now that is a bizarre little gag. I think this... was there a smiley face on here? And it got stuck to my cursor, or did my cursor change to a smiley face before? I don't remember. Oh wow, okay. But yeah, there is a lot of delightful nonsense in this game. How very, ah, fuck, it's not Dumas. Okay. Does it need more weight? Make a big one and put that on there? Will that... okay. I'm making a mistake here. Hmm. Aha, okay. Now, what decides which one they go back to? I'd have assumed it was the original, but the original hadn't moved all the way. Magritte, thank you! Oh my god. See, this is one of the reasons why I didn't do like an art history degree, is just I straight up cannot remember names. It's one of the weirdest things about like my particular experience of ADHD is that I blank on nouns constantly. There's a lot of other things I don't blank on. I mean, there's a lot of things I do blank on as well, but... is their color based on their size? Is the size based on how far away I am? Yes, it is. No, it's not, because those ones are tiny. Huh. Why don't we do it like that? Okay, I guess the size is relative to how close I am to it, but smallness-wise, maybe? Hmm. It's enough to make a good crumble with it, at any rate. But again, yeah, the apple is like one of these kind of generic, thematically weighted objects. I don't want to fall down that hole. Even if it does end up being the way to go. Born free. Free as an apple grows. That doesn't work. The song doesn't work that way. Mm-hmm. So, is there a switch? This is the switch. Can I roll the apple? I bet if I... okay, if I push it into here, is it gonna... oh, they all go down the hole. Okay. So I guess that's meant to be a barrier to stop me getting things up there directly then, I guess? Because I can't push them up the... I can't push them anyway, they don't respond to me. Hmm. Zoop. Maybe I just need to make this hole be as full as possible. Actually, no, what is down here? Let's find out. Okay. So if that's what's down there... then why don't the apples that I draw all the way into this end up falling down from above, huh? Why ain't that happening? Should be coming out that hole. I've spotted a flaw in your brain programming. Hmm, okay, I'm getting stuck again. Since I don't seem to have any way to... resize? I can only clone, right? In this area, I can only clone. If I stand on this, my door opens, but I can't go through because I'm on it. If I do this, I can't bring them any further forwards. If I hide that, does it stop being real? Nope, still blowing stuff. Sure is a good thing I'm clever and not some kind of absolute moron. Just a total fool. My girlfriend is making noises on the other side of the room that imply I am in fact a total fool. Which really I should have seen coming, but you know, I'm a fool. Skip is suitable for general waste. Don't put fill, hard fill in there. The council will charge you. Don't overload above the side or past the end of the skip. Oh, If I make changes to different places so that it goes into different positions, maybe? But that won't, no, that won't work because it's only going to blow them along this line, right? Yeah, the problem with perspective is that I can only really easily make tiny apples, right? If I do it from far away. If I go as far away from possible, that'll make the... I guess part of my problem is I'm not entirely sure what dictates how big the apple it makes is. So I'm not really sure how to make one big enough to like block the skip or whatever. Oh, I'm stumped. That thing about the skip must be a clue, though. This can be solved by cloning one apple. Okay. Or what, making one apple clone? Perception is reality. I mean, the thing about perception is reality is that perception is reality only under very specific rules, and the game decides what those rules are at any given time. I can't resize things right now, after all. So if I clone it like that, it makes a very small one, right? Because it appears in the space in front of me. But if I clone it like that, it's still smaller than it was. It's always going to be a smaller apple. And if I make a clone and drop on it, what happens then? Nothing. Well, I didn't drop on it anyway. Oh, if I go... if I go back this far, I can make one in here. That doesn't help me. Oh, I'm sorry, game. I'm sorry I called you easy. This, incidentally, is why I don't, like, usually let's play puzzle games, because, you know, every half hour or 20 minute episode consists mostly of me going, there is an archive on YouTube, secretly. Oh! So wait, hang on, if I... Oh, fucking hell. Yeah, okay. It's okay, at least I'm pretty.
Dr. Pierce is frantically submitting numerous spelling and grammar mistakes into the standard orientation protocol in a desperate attempt to counsel you. I have no subroutine to correct these errors, but I cannot compromise the integrity of the standard orientation protocol. You will not receive these messages. They would not make sense regardless.
Now, I should have been able to figure that out. I should have put two and two together and realized that it always spawns in front of me, right? So if I spawn it in front of me with something in between us, it would fall on top of it. What was I talking about? Oh, I was talking about the secret archive on YouTube, which is unlisted and only available to certain people, which contains my, like my practice Let's Plays that I made back when I first decided to get back into doing this stuff. There is one of Baba Is You, and there is one of a whole bunch of secret puzzle, not puzzle, then there's like a first attempt at the Bayonetta thing where I get halfway through Bayonetta. Ah, I thought I could grab that. Yeah, the thing about Baba Is You is that Tessa is bad at video game. So if you want to hear me coughing furiously and relentlessly forever while I attempt to, because I was still quite ill from Corona at that time. I've recovered a lot now, although I get bad flare-ups periodically, but I was really ill at the time, and so my Baba Is You episodes are constantly punctuated by edits where I removed serious coughing fits, and I just talk like this the entire time. But yeah, all of my like test episodes, even going back to my original Dark Souls Let's Play.
Dr. Pierce continues to input significant errors. I will interpret his basic ideas. Hello, my introduction. I'm a real doctor who went to Dr. Pierce. The error has never been a mistake. I can help you, but I also do not know how. Transmission ends.
See, I like that. That's made me laugh. Also, this is like a few years later with regards to PC design as compared to where I thought we were. That is not a 1993 PC or whatever year it was. 1991? That is not a PC from 1991. That's like 1996, 1998. Also, you joke, but I did actually title every episode of the Babbitt. This is a rectangle. I forgot about cloning! Infinite soda! Oh, okay. No, I can reposition this. Alright, fair enough. My brief delight at having cracked the capitalist system. Oh hey, it didn't use light. There we go. This reminds me of that time I was playing Deus Ex, and I went to a great deal of effort to squeeze a fridge through a doorway. Well, not a fridge, a vending machine through a doorway. Carry it all the way through up 5 flights of stairs up to the top floor of an apartment building, and then drop it off the top of an apartment building on some guy I didn't like. Those games are fun. Am I deep enough in the dreamscape that I can have infinite soda machines? It's not the same as infinite soda, but it's better than nothing. And yeah, good sound design. Like I was saying when I was making giant cans of soda earlier, there is good sound design in this game. I was talking about something else before that I actually wanted to finish saying. I can't remember what it was. Oh, Baba Is You. I was going to say, no, I smiley face. It didn't detach this time. But I've kept those around, even the archives all the way back to my first, like, very first never for publication attempt at the Dark Souls Let's Play 5 years ago. If I ever start like a Patreon or whatever, it might be a reward for higher backers to get access to my really shitty practice episodes. Pip. Pop pop pip pop pip pop. Good noise. This is a less good noise.
Name is my Pierce Dr. Glenn. To the Somnisculpt Welcome Experience, team of your care leader patient years 10 development. Conditions struggle you whatever with? Professional invention. Edge science with cutting, a tomorrow can bright. And buts, no ifs, or look good.
I know this is just a joke, but this is literally what it's like whenever my audio processing gets bad. Also, my internet has been playing up, so y'all are gonna have to tell me if you like, if I get disconnected or stutters from bad internet or whatever. What if I forget to set the alarm? Is the alarm part of the emergency exit protocol, or is it just like whatever? Phil's friendly family produce. Farm to mind to heart. It's food for the soul. It's food for thought. Food for thought! That would have been where to go with that, right? I can't tell if this one's a joke or if it's just not loading.